find the rise time expression for this particular output waveform. So first we have to find the, so first we have to observe the output waveform. So that is this one is the output waveform occurred at the output side when a step signal is passing through the low pass RC circuit. So at 5 RC, so the maximum value is like this. At 1 RC, the value will be at 0.632, nothing but 63.2. So at T is equal to RC, the value will be 0.62. At the same time, at 5 RC, the maximum value we have to apply. So occur, nothing but the output is touches to the V0 position. So before discussing about this condition, what is meant by rise time, we have to know what is meant by rise time. So rise time nothing but the time taken by a waveform to reach 10% to 90% of its maximum value. So the time required or time taken by a waveform to reach 10% to 90% of its maximum value, so is known as rise time. Simply we can say that, so this is the waveform we have to observe. So the time taken by a waveform, so it is in the 10% stage and it is at the 90% stage. So the time, nothing but this is the time taken by a waveform to reach 10% to 90% is known as rise time. So generally the rise time is indicated with TER. So that is TER nothing but, so 90% minus 10%. Have to write like this or not? So rise time nothing but the time taken by waveform to reach 10% to 90%. So the maximum value is occurred at 90%, that is T2 minus T1. So at T1 position it is right, at 90% it is treated as T2, and at 10% it is treated as 0.14. So just we have to solve the equation, what is the TR we have to find using this waveform. So what is the output of this particular waveform? So the output waveform is in terms of an exponentially increased signal. So what is the derivation or what is the output waveform for this particular exponential signal? That is V0 is equal to V into 1 minus e power minus t by RC. So as we know that we have to substitute different values. So these different values are, so at t is equal to t1 condition, at the same time at t is equal to t2 condition, we have to apply so different values. So then we have to get the TR condition. So first we have to apply at t is equal to, so t1 condition. At t is equal to t1 condition, what is meant by V0 of t? So what is the output voltage where it is? So simply the V0 of t is at 10% level. So in the previous formula, in the previous example, we see that so at t is equal to t1 condition, the waveform is at 10% level only. So then V0 of t becomes 10%. So then V becomes. So 10% nothing but 0.1 volt. So the equation for the final equation is V0 of t is equal to V into 1 minus e power minus t by RC. So as we know this value and substitute this V0 of t. So what is V0 of t? We take as 10% level. So we treat it as 10% level. Then V0 of t becomes 0.1 volt. And V into 1 minus e power minus t by RC. So then we get e power minus t by RC. So nothing but, so by solving this equation, how to solve? Simply V cancelled. So we have to write like this, 0.1 is minus e power minus t by RC. So then what happens about e power t by RC? So then we have to write like this, 1 minus 0.1 volts. So that is e power t by RC is equal to, minus t by RC is equal to 0.9. So that is e power minus t by RC is equal to 0.9 volts. So what is the positive value? That is e power t1 by RC. T nothing but here we take it as t1. So substitute t1 value. Why? Because at t is equal to t1 condition only. So the output V0 of t is equal to 0.1 volts. So that's why at t is equal to t1 condition, So the output voltage is 0.9 volts. So this is a negative, that is e power t1 minus by RC becomes 1 by 0.9. So this value is e power t1 by RC. So then we have to write like this, that is 1.11. So that is e power t1 by RC is equal to 1.11. So when, what is meant by t1, we can say that, so that is t1 becomes, so when we shift to the e power into this line, then it becomes ln. So t1 by RC is equal to ln of 1.11, the same time t1 is equal to RC ln of 1.11. So then the final equation or final answer will be 0.1 RC, so by using 10% level. So at 10% level, the value will be 0.1 RC. So first we have to find, that is what is the t is equal to t1 condition, what is V0? So V0 is at the level of 0.1 volt, nothing but 10%. So then that is in terms of 0.1 volts, substitute these values and we get the t1 value. So in the similar way, we have to solve at t is equal to t2 level, that is at the percentage of 90%. So we have to solve. So at t is equal to t2, what happens? The output voltage V0 of t is equal to 90%. So then V becomes 0.9 volts. So then substitute this value and VV will be cancelled. Then e power minus t by 2 RC becomes, so 1 minus 0.9, that is 0.1 volt. So R e power t2 by RC becomes 1 by this answer, that is 10. And t2 becomes RC ln of 10, that is 2.3 RC. So then what is the equation for the rise time? In the previous slide we have to discuss rise time, nothing but the time taken by waveform to reach 10% to 90%. So at t is equal to t2 level, so the waveform is at 90%. At t is equal to t1, the waveform is at 10% level. So then the rise time formula, rise time which is indicated by tr, that is equal to t2 minus t1. First we have to find t2 as t1 as well as t2, then substitute these values in this equation. So then t2 becomes 2.3 RC minus, and what is meant by t1, that is 0.1 RC. So then the final value, that is rise time tr, is equal to 2.2 RC. So this is very important and very important question for final exams also. So this is the equation for the rise time. So as well as we want to find the, what is the relationship between the rise time as well as 3 dB frequency. So we have to check the condition also. So what is meant by 3 dB frequency? So by using 3 dB frequency only we have to find the bandwidth. So simply we can say that the 3 dB frequency, so F2 becomes, so the 3 dB frequency, we know the formula, F2 is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC. So then we have to know the value of RC. Why? Because TR is equal to 2.2 RC. That's why we know the value of RC and substitute this RC value in this particular equation. So then we get the rise time in terms of 3 dB frequency. So then RC becomes 1 by 2 pi F2. So then what happens? The rise time TR is equal to 2.2 RC. So then what is the value of RC? That is 2 by F2. So then the equation becomes 2.2 by 2 by F2. So and 2.2 by 2 pi, nothing but 0.35 by F2. So nothing but F2 is equal to the bandwidth also, nothing but cutoff frequency is related to the bandwidth, which is equal to 0.35 by bandwidth. So this is the relationship between the upper cutoff frequency and rise time. So these formulas are used for this problem solving. So that's why we have to know the rise time in different methods or different manners. Simply we can say that the rise time is inversely proportional to the upper cutoff frequency. So why? Because here we can say that the rise time 2.2 RC is inversely proportional to the F2. So that is TR is inversely proportional to F2. So at the same time, so the time constant RC of the circuit is defined as the time taken by the output to rise 63.2% of its amplitude of the input step signal. So here T is equal to tau nothing but RC, which is depends upon the, so at T is equal to RC condition we have to substitute, we get the 0.632, that is 63.2%. So that is based upon these value only we have to get the, so particular solution or particular value of RC in this particular equation. So this is about the low pass RC circuit while passing through the step input, as well as the rise time and what is how a rise time is related to the 3 dB frequency. So next one is response of the low pass RC circuit for pulse input. So what is meant by pulse signal and how the output we have to get, so we have to observe. So in this, so first a pulse input, we have to know about the pulse input. So in the high pass circuit also we have to use this pulse signal. So what is meant by pulse input? It maintains a constant V was for 0 less than T less than dB. So the output voltage VA is equal to, or the input voltage VA is equal to, simply we can say that V volts for 0 less than T less than TP, for T greater than TP or T less than 0, nothing but, so T greater than TP and T less than 0, it maintains 0 volts. So otherwise the output voltage VA is equal to 0 volts. What happens when this signal is passing through the low pass RC circuit, we have to observe. First, a constant V volts, that is a step signal. So up to T, in between T less than 0 or 0 less than T less than TP, the output input voltage will be V volts. Then what happens? A constant V volts is applied to the low pass RC circuit. The response is simply like as a step signal response. The response of the this output signal is simply like the step signal response. Simply we can say that a constant signal is applied to the circuit, then positive and negative, a positive signal and it is connected to the ground. So then capacitor starts charging in which way? So as we know that the capacitor charging condition is in terms of exponentially increasing way. So then it starts charging in exponential way. So when next at T is equal to TP condition also the output voltage is in V volts. So at sudden falling also, but here in this condition capacitor does not react with fastly. So then the output voltage Vp is also equal to same condition. So it ends at the position of Vp is equal to V into 1 minus e power t by R. Simply it is in terms of exponentially increased manner only. So when a next at T greater than Tp, so nothing but T greater than Tp, so next a negative, nothing but a 0 volts is applied to the capacitor. So then initially what is the position of capacitor? So initial condition capacitor is in charging condition. So now capacitor starts discharging. What is the discharging position or discharging waveform? Simply the capacitor starts discharging in exponentially decreasing form. So this waveform is like this. So this is the condition while RC greater than TP. So nothing but, so R and C values are greater than TP, then we get this particular waveform. So while RC is less than TP, nothing but, so the capacitor starts charging in capacitor starts charging instantly or with less time, discharging with less time. So then the waveform will be like this. So it may cause distortions. So that is the main problem. So first we have to say that the input, here we have to apply input as well as we get the output. So what is the output solutions or what is the output equations we have to solve? So here the important one, that is the response of the low pass RC circuit for time constant RC greater than TP. So then only, so when RC is smaller than TP and RC is very smaller compared to TP, so we have to observe in the next slide. So this is the waveforms. What is the condition? When RC greater than TP, or RC is far less than TP, RC is very far less than TP. So before discussing about these ones, we have to know what is the So equations for initial stage only. So that is first condition. So at this condition, that is up to 0 <TP. So what happens? Capacitor is initially in charging position. So at the output voltage at T is equal to, so 0 to RTP, we have to say that. So we have to say that that is V01. So then capacitor starts charging exponentially. So then the output voltage V0 of 1 or V1 is equal to, what is the equation for exponential increasing? That is V into 1 minus e power minus t by r. So this is the equation for exponentially increasing. So at next condition, at t is equal to tp. So the voltage is represented with the value of vp only. So the voltage is nothing but the vp, so which is represented with v0 to, so it is vp. See, at which condition? At t is equal to tp condition, the output is simply like this. So then V is equal to, so that is V02 is equal to Vp, which is equal to, so Vp that is equal to, where it starts? V, from V only it starts, that is V into 1 minus e power t, nothing but at which condition we have to substitute this value? At t is equal to Tp condition, that's why. So 1 minus e power minus Tp by Rc. This is equation number 2. So at greater than Tp, so we can say that it is in between T and Tp. So we have to write like this R. So in this time the output is exponentially decreased format. So what is the solution, or what is the observation we have to know, that is what is the equation for the exponentially decreased format, that is, so exponential decrease equation is V0 is equal to V into e power minus t by RC. So substitute these values in this equation. So we can say that that is V03. So up to T value, that is V03. And where it starts, V nothing but it starts at Vp and starts discharging like this. So that's why. So the starting position of V nothing but Vp. And Vp into e power, what is meant by T? So initial condition the T will be normal. At the second position we have to take T is equal to Tp. At third position, so these value is in between T and Tp. So then we have to write like this. So the value is nothing but T minus Tp. So that the equation becomes e power minus T minus Tp by RC. So this is the final value at exponentially decreased form. So this is about the response of the low pass RC circuit for pulse input. So at the initial stage it starts charging. Why? Because the, we take the output across capacitor, then the output is at initial stage up to Tp condition, start charging exponentially. After Tp it starts discharging exponentially. So we have to observe, so different conditions, what is the waveforms we have to observe. So first, already we observed what is the RC greater than T. So while at RC less than T or RC less than T. So why we go for this circuit? Simply we can say that. So compare when RC is greater than T condition only, the distortion will be very less compared with the remaining conditions. So while RC is less than TP, what happens? So this is the waveform we have to observe. So why? Because RC value is far less than T. So then, so capacitor starts charging instantly and at the same time capacitor starts discharging instantly. So then, so it look like this, and at the middle condition it maintains a constant voltage V. So when Vp T is equal to Tp condition, so then capacitor starts discharging initially. So these are the different waveforms we have to observe. So at T is equal to RC greater than T only, we have to observe cut value. So remaining times nothing but RC is less than T or RC is far less than T. So a constant voltage, nothing but we have to observe a constant V volts at some interval of time. We have to observe this particular thing. So this is about the RC high pass circuit response. Sorry, RC low pass circuit response. So while passing through the pulse, sorry, while pulse input is passing through the low pass RC circuit. So in the next class, we discuss about the response of the low pass RC circuit for square wave as well as ramp input. So thank you.